So now it is giving that assurance to their customers by having the certifications for their database.com with the two certifications, ISO 27001 and the SAS 70 type 2 compliance database. So now where internally Salesforce is going to be maintaining only one set of objects. Why? Because as already we have discussed that Salesforce is going to be supporting the multi-tenant architecture where they are going to be providing only one server. Inside the server, they are going to be allocating the memory space for the multiple customers. And for each and every customer, whenever a customer is creating a Salesforce account, that person may be utilizing the free edition of Salesforce. That person may be utilizing the licensed edition of Salesforce also. He may be a licensed user, he may be a free user. For every user, they are going to be allocating the memory inside the same server here. So now in this kind of scenario here, in order to identify each and every customer, now for every customer, they are going to be allocating one unique identification number. Every customer who has created the Salesforce account, they will be called as a Salesforce organization. Every customer will be treated as a Salesforce organization. Now, for every organization, it is going to be allocating one unique identification number that is called as organization ID, which is available inside that company profile. Already, we have discussed yesterday. So now, each and every organization ID will be starting with a 00D. Okay, every organization ID will be starting from 00D. So now, for every organization, we will be having some different unique identification number is available to you. Now, whenever the user is going to be making a request by using their browsers, it may be any browser, whatever they have, in order to access that Salesforce application at that time, whenever they are going to be making a request, then along with their request details, it is going to be forwarding that organization ID also in order to indicate now from which organization this customer has raised the request. Why? Because is whenever the person has created a new record inside that Salesforce database table or inside the Salesforce object, then along with the required record details, it is storing that organization ID also. Inside that organization ID, the currently logged in users organization ID will be getting populated over here. So that in order to differentiate the records between the different organizations and the different users inside that organization. So now, for each and every record, along with the record details, it will be having the organization ID also in order to indicate from which organization this record has been created. Now, inside that organization, if you're having some multiple users are available, so at that time, in order to indicate which user has created this record, it is storing that user ID also. So now, with each and every record, it will be maintaining that organization ID as well as the user ID also in order to indicate which user has created the record, what is the ID of that user, and from which organization he is associated, that organization ID also it will be storing inside that table along with the record. So now here, by using the single set of tables, nothing but by maintaining only one set of standard tables inside the database.com, Salesforce is going to be storing the records of the multiple organization users. So now this is how they are going to be maintaining the security inside that. Now, for example, now when coming to my organization, how can we configure the users here? How can we maintain the multiple users inside my organization? Then what will be the mandatory things that we need to have before creating the users inside that? And if I'm having the multiple users, how these people can able to create the records? If the users has created the record, then how the records visibility will be provided? How can we restrict the visibility of the records from user one user to another user? And how can we make one record to make it visible to multiple users? Then what are the various features available inside that we will be discussing one by one. Now, as we have discussed that, when coming to the organization, in each and every organization, we will be having some users. We can create some users inside that organization here. Now, so now when coming to this organization, So now we are going to be creating some users inside that organization. So we have an organization. Inside an organization, we can have multiple users. Each and every organization will be having the multiple users. So now in this kind of scenario here, whenever you are going to be creating the users, each and every user should be associated with a license. Okay, every user should have a license. Now, for example, so this is the instance that we have from the Salesforce. Assume that this is a North America region server, NA21 or NA2 or NA21, whatever. Assume that here I'm having that North America region server, which is some NA21. So now I have created a new Salesforce account inside that server, and Salesforce has allocated some amount of memory inside the server for me. Now this is the amount of memory has been allocated by the Salesforce to me. So now this is the organization ID. This is my organization. For this organization, Salesforce is allocating some ID for that here. So I'm going to be adding my organization's ID inside that. You are aware of how do you know what is the ID of the organization has been created by the Salesforce. In order to get the ID of your Salesforce organization, okay, in order to get the ID of your Salesforce organization, now we can go to that setup menu. And from the setup menu, go to that administer menu in the left panel. Go to that company profile. And inside that company profile, we are having an option called as company information. Click on company information. And inside that company information details, you will be having a field called as Salesforce.com organization ID. This is the ID has been allocated by Salesforce for my organization. Now copy this ID. I'm going to be pasting over here. This is the organization ID has been allocated by the Salesforce for my organization right now. So now this is the ID has been allocated here. So now with this ID, we can able to perform some operations here. With this ID, we can able to perform some operations. So now as soon as whenever you are going to be creating a new Salesforce organization, along with that Salesforce organization, it is going to be creating a user also. It is going to be creating a user also with the default information. Nothing but whatever the details that you have entered inside the registration form, with those details, it is creating a new user also inside that. Now for this user, it is going to be allocating the system admin permissions. Nothing but system administration permissions it will be giving to you. So now for that here, this person will be having the full rights on this entire organization. This person will be having the full control on this organization so that he can able to do whatever the operations he want. He can able to add some more custom objects also. He can able to add some more custom applications also. He can able to develop some Apex classes, Visual First Pages, everything, the whole features. Whatever the features offered by the Salesforce as part of Salesforce CRM and the first.com platform, everything will be getting accessible to this particular system administrator. And along with that, as a system administrator, he will be having the rights to add some more new users also inside this organization. So now, in this kind of scenario, how can we add these users here? So now, whenever you are going to be adding the users, because here we are having the database, okay, we are having the database inside our organization. So now, assume that this is the database that we have. So I'm having the database. So now I'm having the database for my organization. So now this is the database that I have. Inside the database, I'm having a table. Inside the database, I'm having a table. Assume that this table is the account table. This is the account table. Inside this account table, we are having some set of columns are available here, in which we can able to store some account records inside this account table. You are having some columns inside that. Inside this table, we can able to store some records inside that. So now in order to connect to this particular database, okay, in order to interact with this database, each and every user should have a proper license. Okay, every user should have a proper license. So now without having the license, the user cannot able to connect to the database. They cannot able to perform any operations inside that objects. Then I'm using the free developer edition. Then how can he get the license? So now even though you are using the free developer edition of Salesforce, Salesforce is giving 5 licenses to you by default. They're giving the 5 licenses. Why? Because is without the license, we cannot able to connect to the Salesforce database and we cannot perform any operation. Now, when coming to the Salesforce, they are going to be purely avoiding the piracy concept over here. Suppose, for example, assume that I'm having an organization like some TCS or any organization where TCS is having some more than 2 lakhs employees are there inside that organization in the entire worldwide. So now, for every employee, they have to allocate a system. It may be a laptop, it may be a desktop. In every laptop or desktop, they have to install that operating system mandatorily. It may be the Windows, it may be anything. Assume that for all the system, they are going to be configuring the Windows operating system. So now then how many licenses they need to buy? For each and every user, they need to install the separate Windows operating system so that they have to buy a separate license. Nothing but they need to buy 2 lakhs licenses of Windows operating system. But now, when coming to the TCS people, they will buy those many number of licenses? No. They will be by purchasing one license and they are going to be creating the image copy, the same image copy they are going to be dumping into the multiple instances. Nothing but what happened, they are going to be making some copies of the same license and they are going to be installing into the multiple devices as well. Nothing but there is a chance of piracy is there. But when coming to the Salesforce, even though you may be having your organization, without a proper license, nobody can able to connect to the Salesforce database. For every user, we should have a license. If the user is having license, then only he can able to enter into the Salesforce database and he can able to perform the operations inside that. Without having the proper license, they cannot able to enter into the Salesforce database and they cannot able to perform any operations inside that. So now for that, each and every user should have a proper license. Now assume that we are having some users are there, like some user one. So assume that we are having some user one and I'm having some user two.
See, in that case, Firoz, the editions and the licenses are sort of different, right?
Yes.
Okay.
So this is a user one and this is a user two. I'm having the two users are there. Each and every user should have a license. Okay, every user should have a license. That license will decide on what applications this user will be having the access on that. Now, when coming to the Salesforce, Salesforce is providing the different types of licenses to you here. Now every user should have a proper license. Assume that I'm having some license one. And along with that, I'm having some license two. So now these licenses we are going to be associating with these particular users. Now this license one will be associated to that user one. And this license 2 will be associated to the user 2. Whenever if the user wants to perform any operation inside that objects of Salesforce by connecting to the database, then they should have a proper license. Without the license, the user cannot able to perform any operation. Nothing but there is no concept of piracy. Every user, if you are having some 1 lakh users, then 1 lakh licenses you should have. If you are having 10 users, then you should have 10 licenses here. So now, already we have discussed about that. So now when coming to the user licenses, these are purely based on the rental concept. These are purely based on the rentals. Now for every month, you have to pay some amount here. Okay, for every month, you have to pay some amount to that Salesforce. This is rental amount. It's not the whole amount we are going to be paying at a time to buy the whole license of the Salesforce. So now depends upon the number of users. If your business is keep on growing, so if you are going to be adding so many number of employees inside that organization, for each and every new employee, we have to buy a separate license from the Salesforce. So now every user should have a proper license. Now, when coming to the licenses here, how many licenses that we have inside our Salesforce right now? When coming to the Salesforce, Salesforce is providing the different types of licenses to you. Okay, it is providing the different types of licenses to you. Like, when coming to the Salesforce, they are going to be offering the Salesforce licenses. This is also called as full license. And they're offering the platform license. And then they're offering some charter license. And they're offering some community licenses also. Community licenses. So now, Salesforce is providing some licenses to you by default here. Now, when coming to the Salesforce, they are going to be offering some set of licenses to you by default so that we can able to have the taste of Salesforce. Not only as a single user, even though you are using the free developer edition, for every free developer edition, Salesforce is providing some licenses to you. Then how many licenses Salesforce is offering to me? Now let's see here. When coming to the Salesforce, Salesforce is going to be offering the two full licenses to you. Nothing but two Salesforce licenses. And along with that, they're offering the three platform licenses to you. And along with that, they are going to be offering 5,000 charter licenses to you as a free developer edition. And they're offering the five community licenses to you by default here. Nothing but even though you are using the free developer edition of Salesforce, then Salesforce is going to be offering some set of licenses to you by default and free of cost to you. And free of cost to you, Salesforce is going to be offering some set of licenses to you over here. So now Salesforce is offering the two full licenses to you, and the three platform licenses, and the 5,000 charter free licenses, and the five community licenses here. These are the various licenses Salesforce is offered to you by default for each and every free developer organization. So now for each and every free developer edition. For each and every free developer edition, Salesforce is going to be offering these licenses to you. Now, we are having that two full licenses, three platform licenses, and the 5,000 charter licenses, and the five community licenses inside our free developer edition. So now, what is the difference between this full license and the platform license? Full license is also called as Salesforce license. Okay, full license is also called as Salesforce license, where Salesforce license is going to be granting the access to this user on all the Salesforce CRM standard functionalities as well as the custom applications also. So whatever the standard functionalities given by the Salesforce as part of Salesforce CRM, and along with that, whatever the custom applications the user has implemented, whatever the custom the application they have developed, all those applications they can able to access by using this full license. And when coming to the platform license is purely concentrating on platform part. Platform is nothing but force.com platform. By using that force.com platform, whatever the applications that you have built, whatever the custom application that you have built, whatever the Apex classes that you have written, whatever the Visual First pages that you have prepared, whatever the triggers that you have written, nothing but purely on the development part it is going to be concentrating right now. Nothing but in order to build your own custom application, in order to access your own custom application which you have built, we have to use that platform license. And along with that, it is going to be granting the access on very few standard functionalities of Salesforce. Like as account, and the contact, and the opportunity, these three objects are visible to you, and along with that, you will be having all your custom objects, custom applications, custom functionalities inside that. You will not be able to access each and every standard feature of Salesforce. Now, for example, I will tell you one small difference here. Whenever you are using that Salesforce license, you can able to access all the Salesforce objects, like as account object, contact object, opportunity object, case object, solution object, lead object, campaign object, product object, price book object, every object we can able to access. But whenever you are using that platform license will be granting the access on only a few standard objects of Salesforce. Like account object you can access, contact object you can access, and the opportunity object you can access, but case objects, solution objects, lead objects will not be visible to you inside this platform license. Platform license is purely concentrating on the custom functionalities. Like, because here, sometimes already we have discussed initially. Now, whatever the ready-made application is there, if the ready-made application is suitable, then we can able to access that. If the ready-made application is not at all suitable, then at that time, we have to go for our custom development. We have to go for our custom application development based on our requirements. So at that time, we have to go for that platform license. Nothing but only I want to develop my own application. I don't want any standard Salesforce CRM application. Because I am into the banking, but Salesforce is offering CRM, but already I'm having my own CRM is there, so that I don't want the Salesforce CRM, so that I want only my banking application I want to implement. So now to implement my banking application, whatever the resources required, whatever the programming languages, whatever the technologies, whatever the databases are required, I want to access only those things. I want only the platform part. I want only the development environment part by which I can build my own custom application. So for that here, we can able to buy the platform license itself instead of having the Salesforce license. Now, this platform license is purely concentrating on the custom applications development to you. Whatever the custom applications that you have built, whatever the custom functionalities that you have built, only those functionalities we can able to access. Now, so now for each and every user, we should have a proper license here. Next, the charter license. Charter license is...
Question. If the user has a platform license, they cannot access the sales application, marketing application. That was you're referring, right, Siros?
Yes.
Okay.
Now, so now when coming to the charter licenses, like as your communities, you will be having some charter functionality, like just we can able to post some information and somebody can able to view that information. They can able to comment on that or they can able to like on that. Like as you will be having your Facebook, you will be having your Twitter. Like that here, if you want to provide any charter kind of application, then we can able to have maximum of 5,000 charter free licenses available to you. And after that, we can able to configure your communities also in Salesforce, where there might be so many partners are available. Those partners, we can able to make it as a community, and you will be having your customers. We can able to make all the customers to be on the same platform so that they can able to communicate with each other. They can able to share some information. They can able to share some knowledge and everything. So at that time, in order to place all our partners and the customers on a single platform, so at that time, we can able to create our communities as well. So now for that community, Salesforce is giving a separate license to you. In our Salesforce, we are going to be discussing about two communities. One is the Salesforce partner community, and we are discussing about the customer community also here. So now what exactly the Salesforce partner community and the customer community, we'll see practically in the later sessions. How can we configure those customer communities and the partner communities over there?
Rose, which license developer use?
Now developers are going to be using that Salesforce license, because as a developer, whenever you got a requirement, then we have to think first in the admin side. Nothing but whether this requirement can be possible to implement with the help of the configuration or not. Nothing but configuration means the ready-made features of Salesforce. So that here he should be having the knowledge on, he should be having the access on each and every standard feature available in Salesforce. If that feature can be able to accessible with the help of, can be implementable with the help of that ready-made features, then we can able to implement. If the ready-made functionalities are not supported, then at that time we have to go for that development, so that you should be having the access on the admin features, you will be having the access on development features, all the functionalities on which we should have the access. So for that here, always for each and every developer, they have to grant the access on Salesforce license. Every developer will be having the Salesforce license, and along with that, every developer should have the system administration permission. Why? Because is if you're not having the system administration permission, then you cannot able to access all the features of Salesforce. So, but as a developer, we don't know on which functionality we are going to work upon. That will be decided by our requirement here. At that time, if you want to work on any feature of Salesforce, if you are able to access any feature in Salesforce, it may be admin side, it may be development side, then you should be having the full control on that application, so that you should be having that system administration permission. But if the application is restricted to only admin, they will be granting some permission to you which are required based on that application development.
I mean, it's little bit I mean, it's not related to this particular topic, but I just want to know. I mean, in an organization, there are four or five sandboxes, like developer, one is full, and one is the production.
Okay.
So, at the time of pricing, do they need to ask about this? I mean, they need, like, suppose 17 developer development sandbox, two full, and one production?
Yes. See, whenever the customers are going to be purchasing the license, by default, it is providing the production instance to you. Okay, by default, it is providing the production instance to you. Now, let me show you that. Now see, so assume that I have a client. Okay, assume that I have a client. The client is nothing but some Merck Pharma. Merck is a client, which is a US-based organization who are purely into the pharmaceutical domain, who are going to be manufacturing some products, like some pharmaceutical products they're manufacturing right now. So now they're having their business into the different locations, and they're having the branches in different countries. Whatever the pharmaceutical products they have manufactured, they would like to sell out these products to the various places in the entire world. So now for that, they are going to be appointing some medical representatives. These medical representatives are going to be visiting the different hospitals in the different places. They are meeting the different doctors, and they are going to be requesting those doctors to please suggest our products also. So now we are into so and so organization. We are manufacturing this kind of products, which are purely using to cure this kind of diseases. It may be for the heart diseases. It may be for the anyone, any of the disease, whatever. Now, these are very specialized products which we have manufactured, which is going to be curing these kind of diseases. And then please suggest our products also to your patients. And then we will be keep on in touch with you in order to get the feedback. If there is any negative impacts, if there is any feedbacks are there, we need to collect those feedbacks also from you. So for that, they are going to be appointing so many medical representatives. They are going to be meeting the various doctors in the different hospitals. So now initially they will be meeting the doctor by taking the appointment, and they are going to be requesting them, this is our product, this is our organization, please suggest our products also. Now, once the doctor has been prescribed these products to that any of the patients, then after 1 week time, again, the medical representative are going to be contacting the doctor again. He will be meeting the doctor to get the feedback. So now have you prescribed this particular product to any of your patients or not? If you have prescribed, then what will be the result? The patient is satisfied or patient is not satisfied with that, then what will be the feedback here? So further, they're going to be keep on in touch with those doctors. So now in this kind of scenario, in order to manufacture the product, in order to sell out the product, whatever the process they have following, in order to automate that process, they would like to use some Salesforce application. So now because that application can be accessible by the medical representative at any point of time, so that they can be able to access this application through their smartphones also. Because every time they cannot able to carry a laptop, every time they cannot able to carry a desktop to that hospital, to the doctor. So for that here, in order to get the feedback from the doctor also, just they can able to access the Salesforce application from the smartphone, and they can able to give the smartphone to the doctor. In that application, they will be having a small form. He will be filling up the form regarding his feedback. When he click on submit, this will be coming to my Salesforce instance automatically. So that further flexibility, they would like to use some Salesforce application. So now assume that Merck people know how to implement, how to manufacture that pharmaceutical product, but they don't know how to develop a software application. Further, they are going to be contacting an organization. Assume that they are contacting an organization called as some TCS. Now TCS is a very big organization. So now, which is having some different customers who are serving to the different customers who are in the different domains. So now let's assume that TCS people are ready to develop this application for the client, Merck Pharma. So now for the Merck, TCS is the vendor, and for TCS, Merck is the client. So now TCS people are having so many Salesforce resources are there, so many Salesforce developers are there. Now these people are ready to work on this Merck Pharma application. So now at that time, when Merck people are going to be giving the requirement documents to the TCS people, now the people has given the complete information, nothing but they have made the sign off here. Nothing but they made the sign off, nothing but they have accepted to develop this application. In order to develop this application, whatever the resources are required, whatever the licenses are required, whatever the tools are required, whatever the softwares are required, everything has to be provided by the client itself. So that Merck Pharma people has to buy the licenses of Salesforce and they have to provide to the TCS people. Now the TCS employees will use that licenses and they will build the application based on the requirement given by the Merck Pharma. So now, when coming to the Merck Pharma people, they have to buy the license. Then how they are going to purchasing the license here? In order to purchase the license of Salesforce, they can able to contact the Salesforce directly, or they can able to contact the Salesforce partners also. In order to buy the license, no need to contact the Salesforce directly. We can able to contact the Salesforce partners also. So now, when coming to the Merck Pharma people, they are from the US organization, they are from the US country. So that here, they are going to be purchasing the license of Salesforce. Whenever the client is going to be purchasing the license of Salesforce, depends upon the country which he is associated, they are going to be allocating some amount of space inside that associated region's available server. Now Merck is from the US, so now US will be comes under the North America region, so that in that North America regions, whatever the servers are available from the servers and the required amount of memory will be allocating inside a specific server here. You are aware of what are the various servers available in the North America region, like as NA0 to NA45. In Europe region, they're having the servers from EU0 to EU6. In the Asia Pacific region, they're having the servers from AP0 to AP4. So now in that North America region, whatever the servers are available, in those servers, they are going to be allocating some amount of memory here. Agenda for this North America, for this Merck Pharma client, they have allocated some amount of space inside that North America region, that is sixth server. So now whenever the people are going to be purchasing the license, then they have to specify that in edition, which edition of Salesforce they want to use. Already we have discussed initially what are the various editions of Salesforce. Now almost most of the organizations are going to be purchasing that unlimited edition of Salesforce. Now they have purchased that unlimited edition of Salesforce right now. In this unlimited edition of Salesforce, we can build unlimited number of applications and you can able to add unlimited number of users also, keep on by adding some licenses as well for every user. So now inside this North America region, that is sixth server, they are going to be allocating some amount of memory here. So now, do we need to develop this application by logging into the production here? Nothing but whatever the North America region that we have, this is nothing but the production instance. Okay, this is nothing but the production instance. Whatever the servers that we have, like as EAP servers and the North America region servers and the Europe region server, these are all are nothing but the production instances. Whatever the developer edition that you are using right now, the developer edition itself, it is nothing but a production instance to you. Now, so for that here, then how do we know which one is the production, which one is the sandbox? So now at that time, whenever you are logging into that Salesforce, in that Salesforce, you will be having the URL. Nothing but you will be having this address bar is there. In this address bar, you will be having the URL. In that URL, if this URL will be having the servers like as AP servers, nothing but AP2 here we are having right now. Nothing but if the memory has been allocated in AP server or North America region server or the Europe region server, these are nothing but the production instances. And then, when coming to the servers, whenever you are logging into some sandboxes, it will be having the servers like a CS server. Nothing but CS means customer sandbox. CS means customer sandbox. So now for that here, once they have purchased the license of unlimited edition of Salesforce, now in order to build your application, okay, in order to build your application, they are going to be providing some developer environment. Because directly we cannot able to play with the production data. We cannot work on the production instance. So for that here, we are going to be having the multiple instances. Depends upon that client, depends upon the project, depends upon the complexity of the project, they are going to be defining that landscape of that organization or the application. So now for that here, they are going to be from that production instance, this is the production instance. From the production instance, they are going to be configuring a sandbox. Now after that, from the this sandbox is nothing but for the stage instance, nothing but is for the stage server. And after that, they are going to be creating a UAT server. This is also a sandbox. And from there, they're creating a QA sandbox. From there, they're creating the developer sandbox. Now, our role is available in this developer sandbox right now. Our role is available in this particular place. As a Salesforce developer, our role is available in this particular location here. Now, for every developer, they are going to be allocating some sandbox. Now, one sandbox we can allocate to a single developer, or we can allocate one sandbox to the multiple developers also. That possibility is available to you. So now, you will be having the sandbox. Sandbox is nothing but a developer environment where the developer people can able to log into the sandbox. They can able to build the application. From there, they can able to deploy that application to the various instances till to the production here. So now who is going to be configuring these sandboxes here? Now these sandboxes will be created by the Salesforce administrator. Inside your organization, one person will be working as your Salesforce administrator, who is going to be taking care of configuring the whole landscape, and who is taking care of the deployments process, who is taking care of the user management process as well. If any of the new team member has been joined into your project, in order to grant access on your Salesforce instance, he is going to be creating that new person member as a user, so that that new member also can able to access your Salesforce application, and they can able to work on some functionalities as well. So now for that here, we can able to implement that sandboxes. Now in the developer sandbox, we can implement the code. From there, we can move to that QA sandbox where the people can able to log in into the QA sandbox to test the functionality. From there, we can move it to the UAT. From there, we can move it to the stage. And from there, we can move it to the production here. So this is the landscape that we are going to be following. But this landscape is not fixed for every organization. Depends upon the organization, depends upon the project, depends upon the client. They are going to be having the different landscapes over here. Now,
Sorry to ask you. The developers sandbox one, developer sandbox two, developer sandbox. If you consider this landscape, so each developer will have its own sandbox.
Yes, yes.
So if I'm working myself and other, my team member is working on some common piece, for example, one like Apex or class, or not Apex class, is not. A Visual Force screens.
Okay.
How do they communicate within two different sandboxes? If I have one screen of Visual Force and he has one screen of Visual Force, this should interact, right? How that happens, Fios?
So at that time, in order, once you have implemented this functionality, then we are going to be maintaining your version controllings. Okay, we can able to maintain your version controlling. Like as whatever the version controlling systems that we have, we can able to get the whole code of all the developers into a single instance also. Like, for example, developer one is working on the admin module. Developer two is working on some finance module. Developer three, nothing but they are using the another module like as the distribution module or the sales module, whatever. So now at that time, once all these developers has implemented the code, then they can able to place that code into a single repository. Nothing but we can maintain a version control. From that version control, every day the developers are going to be committing the changes, nothing but the code. And from there, each and every other developer can able to get that code into that Salesforce instance. So now for that here, in order to get the code of one developer into the another developers, we can able to use that chain sets. Nothing but we can able to access the functionality with the help of the chain sets as well. So for that here, we are going to be using the chain sets option. This is one of the feature given by the Salesforce by which we can able to deploy the code from one developer sandbox to another developer sandbox over here. Okay.
Okay. Sorry. It's just like a RAD. Different persons, typical Java application will, each developer will have its own RAD and they'll have SVN to check in. And the, okay,
yes.
Got it.
Like the same way here also, we can maintain whatever the version controlling tool that we have. Like as TFS we can use, or we can use VSS also. We can use SVN. We can use GitHub. We can use a source tree. Like that, multiple version controlling tools are there. Everybody can able to connect to that version controlling tool, and from there they can able to pull the data. They can able to commit those changes also into that version controlling. That flexibility is there.
I have one confusion. So from the production, we make this sandbox, right? UAT, yes. Instance, and developer.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so all the sandboxes we have to configure from the production. Why? Because is whenever you are purchasing the license, Salesforce is giving only the production instance to you. In that production instance, they will be giving that these many number of sandboxes that we can able to create. When coming to the sandbox, we are going to be discussing the later session that we are having the different types of sandboxes are there. One is the developer sandbox. Second one is the developer pro sandbox, that is also called as configuration only sandbox. And then we are having that partial copy sandbox, and we are having full copy sandbox. These are the four types of sandboxes are available again. So now in the later sessions, we are going to be discussing about these sandbox types also. Okay.
Okay.
Because the version control should be in cloud or in a local, like for typical Java application, that will be a local SVN, right? In this Salesforce, it could be a cloud, like TFS, Microsoft TFX is a cloud, right?
Yes.
Do we use SVN locally also?
Yes, you can use SVN locally also. You can use your local on-premise, or you can use that cloud also. Depends upon your need.
Oh, okay.
But in order to interact from the version controlling to that Salesforce instance. Why? Because yes, suppose, for example, we are the developer one, and you are the developer two, and the Sridhar is the developer three. Now we are all three are using the three different sandboxes. Now we have done our application development. We have moved that code to that version controlling. And once you have moved that code into the version controlling, from there, where we need to move, we have to move to the other instances. Nothing but to the QA or to the production, to the UAT or whatever. Nothing but from that version controlling, we can able to move that code to the other any other instances available in Salesforce also. Instead of moving each and every developer's changes separately to that QA instance, we can able to club all the changes inside the version controlling. At a time, we can move all the changes to that QA instance also. That flexibility will be available to you. At that time, we
will
use the Jenkins server.
Firoz, suppose Salesforce provided us like 10 GB of space for the production. And I am breaking this sandbox like a developer, developer to a QA. So this also break the size of the which provided from Salesforce?
Yes. It will be getting that memory from that production instance itself.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Now, so when moving forward, we are going to be discussing during the deployments concept, we are going to be discussing a bit more information about this particular landscapes here. Now,
Firoz,
yeah,
are we going to discuss moving like deploying one server to another server?
Yes, means, yes. Deployment also
okay, practically.
Now for each and every organization, it may be the North America region server, it may be the Asia Pacific region server, it may be the Europe region server, and each and every region server, you will be having the multiple organizations are available. In each and every organization, you will be having some set of users. In order to interact with the database table, every user should have a proper license. By using that license, only the Salesforce developers or the Salesforce users can able to communicate with that the Salesforce database, and they can able to perform the required operations inside that. Now, in this kind of scenario here, whenever you are going to be creating a new user record, compulsory we should have a license. Okay, every user should be associated with a license. Without that license, we cannot able to add any user record. Now, for example here, assume that I am having some licenses are available. In that license, we can able to divide the multiple profiles also. Now, for example here, assume that I am having few licenses available. So assume that I'm having few licenses available here. Now, from those licenses, I'm having some users are there. Now, for some users, I want to grant only some applications functionality. For some users, I want to grant only some different applications accessibility. So now, even though you may be having some licenses, even though you may be having some users, multiple users are there who are utilizing your Salesforce license. At that time, for some users, I want to grant only some applications like as application and application two, only these two applications they can able to access. And now I'm having some more users inside my organization. Those people can able to access application three and application four also. So at that time, how can we differentiate the visibility of that application features from one user to another user? So for that here, when coming to the license, from this each and every license, we have to create a profile. Okay, from every license, we can able to.
Feroz, I'm sorry. Yep. You're saying that the license is shared between the users, or each user gets only one license?
Each user should have only one license. Every user should have.
And what about the profile? So how do we set the profile? So each profile is set per license per user, is it?
See. So now every profile will be associated with a license, but one license can have multiple profiles. Okay, I will come to that point here. I'm coming to that point right now. Now give me a minute. So now, when coming to the licenses here, every user should have a separate license. Okay, every user should have a separate license. In order to create a new user record, we should be associating that user with a license here. So now, when coming to the license, each and every license will be associated with the multiple profiles. Okay, every license will be associated with the multiple profiles over here. So now here we are going to be creating some profile. Now assume that here I'm creating the two profiles right now. I'm creating the profiles. So like I'm creating the profile one and the profile two. Some profile one and the profile two. So now this is the profile one and the profile two right now. And then this is the profile two. This is the profile two. So now when coming to the Salesforce instance, each and every license will be associated with the profiles. Every license will be associated with a profile. So at that time, one license can be associated with the multiple profiles. So now in this case, observe the associations here. We are having the associations like profile to license, license to profile. So now profile. So now one profile can be associated. One profile can be associated with only one license. But one license can be associated with the multiple profiles. So nothing but between profile to license. Okay, profile to license is 1-to-1. And license to profile is 1-to-many. So this is the association that we have. So now in this case.
Excuse me first.
Yeah.
By means of saying license, you are saying user. I mean, one profile can have multiple users, but one user can have only one profile, right?
Yes.
I think it's confusing, Feroz, here. Sorry to ask you that. One profile can have one profile can
yes.
see yeah. to multiple
the
licenses.
Association, right? See, the association is, so now every user should be associated with a profile. And then profile will be associated with the license here. Okay, profile will be associated with that license which we have. So now, when coming to the users here, every user should be having a profile. Now, along with that, it is going to be using one Salesforce license also to you. Now, let me show you here practically. For example, let me create a user. Now, you can get some idea on that. So now inside this Salesforce, already we have discussed that when coming to the Salesforce organization for every free developer edition, it is providing some set of licenses to you by default. Then how can we cross-check? Okay, how can we cross-check that every user should be associated with a license? Now, how many licenses Salesforce has given as of now to you? And how many licenses we have used as of now? How many licenses are remains? Now let's see practically here. So now in this case, In order to cross-check that, how many licenses Salesforce has given to you by default, we can able to cross-check this information here. So now when you go to that community, sorry, when you go to that company information, inside that company information, you will be having these licenses to you. So now observe this one here. They have given that table. Inside that table, they have given clearly that how many licenses Salesforce has offered to you as a free developer edition. They have offered the license type, user licenses type. Now the Salesforce license type, then they have given two and one we have used as of now. Nothing but whenever you are creating a new Salesforce account, at that time Salesforce is creating one Salesforce user also. That user will be occupying this license. So that here one license already we have used and we are having one license remains. And then for the Salesforce platform, Salesforce is giving the three platform licenses to you. We haven't assigned any user to these licenses so that these three remains to us. Community licenses, they have offered to you five. Okay, they have offered the five community licenses to you. Like that here, they are giving that each and every license to you. And along with that, we can able to get each and every license information also. Now let's see. When you go to that system overview, here also they are giving this information to you that when coming to the Salesforce people, now they have offered the two licenses to you. From that, we have used one license as of now. Now maximum of two they have given, nothing but these are Salesforce licenses. Charter free licenses, how many? 5,000 charter free licenses they have offered to you, but we have used only one as of now. Community licenses, how many? Five. Maximum five they have given, but we haven't used any license as of now here. So now whenever you are going to be creating the user, okay, now it is going to be indicating how many licenses are available, how many licenses we have used as of now. Suppose, for example, whenever if I'm creating one more user automatically, okay, one more user automatically, then that user should be associated with a license here. That user should be associated with a license so that whatever the two licenses are available, we can able to use those two full licenses also. So now when coming to the user, every user should be associated with a profile, and then every profile will be associated with a license automatically by default to you. So now you will be having one user and then the one profile, but one profile can be assigned to the multiple users also to you. That flexibility will be available. Like the same way, like as the profile to license one-to-one, here also you will be having one user can be associated with one profile. So now we'll see practically here. Come to that, the profile information, what exactly the profile, then you will be getting some idea on this. So now when coming to the profile, so what exactly the profile, what is the use of profile here? Basically, when coming to the profile, profile is nothing but a component. Profile is nothing but a component which contains the set of permissions to be assigned to one or more users. Whatever the permissions that you are going to be assigning to one or more users, those permissions we can able to place inside a single place, and then we can able to assign this permission to the multiple users as well. So now for that here, we are going to be maintaining a component where when coming to the profile is a mediator between the users and the Salesforce application. Whenever the user is trying to be performing some operations inside that table or inside that application, then compulsory every request has to pass through the profile. Salesforce is going to be verifying whether this user will be having the rights to perform this operation or not. That permissions we are defining inside the profile here. So now each and every user restrictions and the user visibility we are going to be specifying inside the profile. Now the profile will decide what operations the user can perform inside the Salesforce organization, what objects he can able to access, and each and every object what operations they can able to perform, what page layouts he can able to access, what record types he can able to access, what applications he can able to access, and what system permissions can be applicable for these users. Everything will be getting decided inside that profile itself. So now here, when coming to the user, each and every user should be associated with a profile. So now, every user should be associated with a profile. So without the profile, we cannot create any user. Without the profile, we cannot create a new user record. We cannot create a new user record inside that Salesforce. Every user should be associated with a profile. Now, whenever you are going to be associating that, one user can be associated with only one profile. One user should be associated with only one profile. But one profile can be associated. One profile can be assigned to multiple users. The flexibility is there. Nothing but profile to users, we are having one to many association. And then user to profile, we are having one to one association. Okay, user to profile, we are having one to one association. And the profile to user, we are having one to many association. So now in this kind of scenario, how can we create this profile here? When coming to the Salesforce, Salesforce is providing the two types of profiles basically here. Salesforce is providing the two types of profiles basically by default. So we have two types of profiles in Salesforce. One is the standard profile. Second one is the custom profiles. One is the standard profile. Second one is the custom profiles. So what do you mean by standard profile? What do you mean by custom profile here? When coming to the standard profile, these are the ready-made profiles given by the Salesforce by default. Whenever you are accessing the Salesforce CRM application, Salesforce is providing some set of ready-made objects to you, like as account, contact, opportunity, lead, case, everything. Along with that, in each and every table, they're providing some records also in order to see that sample records, how the user has to be create some records, what kind of data they have to enter in each and every field to have a sample record. They are giving some set of records to you. Like the same way, when coming to the Salesforce, Salesforce is providing some set of ready-made profiles to you also. These are the ready-made profiles provided by Salesforce by default. Provided by default. So like we are having some profiles called as system administration permissions, system administrator profile, read-only profile, and you will be having authenticated user profile, and then you will be having Salesforce standard user profile. And you will be having platform user profile. Like that, Salesforce is providing some set of ready-made profiles to you. So now when coming to the profile, profile is a mediator between the user and the Salesforce application, which will decide what operations the user can perform inside that Salesforce organization. So now at that time, whatever the permission that you want to grant, okay, whatever the permission that you want to grant, those permissions we can able to specify inside the profile. Suppose, for example, come to a general scenario. Assume that we are going to be having an organization. Assume that I have a TCS organization. In the TCS organization, they have a very big campus, nothing but a very big, the campus is there for the TCS, where in that campus, they're having the various, the cubicles are there, the various rooms are also available, conference rooms are there, and along with that, they're having the server rooms also. Now, every day, when coming to the TCS organization, so many members are joining as new employees. Every day, so many new employees are going to be joining into the TCS. Whenever a new employee has been joined into the TCS, then that employee will be the part of that organization from now onwards, because he is also joining today. He is a new joinee. so that as a new joinee, he is a part of our organization so that he can able to move around the entire organization premises also. So further, in order to grant the permission to enter into those conference rooms, in order to enter into those various cubicles, they are going to be allocating one access card. That access card is nothing but the profile which will decide up to what resources he can able to utilize inside that organization premises. Now, whenever a new person has been came to that organization for to attend the interview, for that they are giving a separate access card, nothing but like as a guest. Now, for the employee, they are going to be giving a separate access card who will be having the permission to open the doors. They can able to enter into the whole organization premises. They can go to the cafeteria. They can go to the conference rooms and everywhere. But those people cannot able to enter into the server room because as a developers, as a testers, at the, all the employees, they cannot able to enter into the server room. That server room permissions will be available only for the network administrator or the system administration people. Nothing but what happened, how they are going to be deciding, they are going to be preparing some set of permissions, and those permissions they are going to be placing inside a component called as an access card. That access card will decide what up to what resources we can able to utilize inside that organization premises. Whenever you are swiping out your access card inside that the server room, it will, the door will not get opened because you are not having the rights to enter into that server room. But whenever a network administrator or the system administrator is going to be swiping his access card in front of that the swipe machine for that server room, automatically the door will be getting opened because that person is having that rights. So now in this kind of scenario, we can able to place all those permissions inside a single component. That component we are going to be assigning to each and every user. Like as here, for each and every employee, they are going to be allocating one separate access card. Now we are having some 10 developers are there inside my team. All are developers only. So everybody will be having their own access card. But in every access card, they will be having the same permissions are available to you. Okay, same permissions are available to you. So now inside this kind of scenario here, when coming to the network administrator people, they are going to be deciding if the new employee has been joined, if the member is like as a developer or a tester or the admin person, like as a now admin developer or the tester, then what will be the permission they need? If he's a network administrator person, then what permission they need? So that they are going to be defining all the permissions, the permission they're placing inside that access card. Based on that access card, they are going to be giving the permission to those employees. Like the same way here also, we can able to define a set of permission which needs to be get assigned to the users. So now, whenever you are going to be providing all the permissions, that permissions related to your Salesforce application, that permission related to your Salesforce objects, your records information, and the operations which they can perform on the records, like as insertion, updation, deletion, retrieval of the record, what operation that you want to grant, on what application that you want to grant the access. Everything we can able to specify those permissions also inside that profile, and that profile we can able to assign to one or more users. Now, when coming to the Salesforce, Salesforce is providing some set of ready-made profiles to you by default. Now, whatever the profiles are given by the Salesforce, these are ready-made profiles and which cannot be removing from that application. Nothing but we can't remove the standard profiles. We cannot remove the standard profiles provided by Salesforce. Whatever the profiles given by the Salesforce, those profiles we cannot able to remove. Okay, we cannot remove those standard profiles given by the Salesforce. And then, if you want to assign these profiles to your users, then at that time, what will happen? Whatever the ready-made profiles given by the Salesforce, we cannot update. We can't update all the features in the standard profile. We can modify the standard profiles up to some extent. Nothing but only some options we can able to modify. We cannot modify each and every option available inside the standard profile. That's what here, always they are going to be recommending to create your own custom profile and assign your custom profile to your users. Don't assign the standard profiles to your users, because standard profiles, everything you cannot able to modify. All the features of standard profile you cannot able to modify because this is a ready-made features given by Salesforce to us. So that it is always recommended. It is always recommended to have our own custom profiles and assign the custom profiles, assign the profiles to the users. If it is a custom profile, we can remove the custom profile in future. We can remove the custom profile when it is no longer needed. And then we can modify all features inside the custom profile because it is our own. It's my own. I have created that custom profile here so that here it's my own, so that I'm the owner. So as I'm the owner, I will be having the full rights on that profile so that I can modify whatever the feature that I want. So now for that here, always it is recommended to create your own custom profile instead of having the standard profiles given by the Salesforce. Now don't assign any standard profiles to your users. Now create your own custom profile and then assign that custom profile to your users where the custom profiles can be modified by the user. In future, if you want to remove that custom profile, if it is no longer needed for you, you can remove that custom profile also from that, the profiles also. So now when coming to the profile, whatever the profiles are available, all the profiles will be storing inside an object called as profile object. All profiles will store inside the profile object. Inside the profile object. Now, when coming to the profile, each profile will be associated with a license. Each profile is associated with a license. Now then, how can we create the custom profiles? What are the profiles available in Salesforce? Now let's see practically here. If you want to see the profiles information, okay, if you want to see the profiles information, then go to that Salesforce instance, click on setup menu, click on setup menu, go to that administrator menu in the left panel, go to the administrator menu, go to that manage users. This is the first option inside that administrator menu. Expand that, you will be having a link called as profiles. When you click on profiles, it is listing out all the profiles to you where each and every profile will be associated with a user license. Now let's see here. These are the profiles are given by the Salesforce to you, totally 36 profiles that we have. If you want to see all those profiles, we can able to see all those profiles also here. If you want to see only some 10 profiles at a time, then you can see 10 profiles here. So now observe this one here. This is one, these are the profile names are there. These are the profile names are there. Now these profiles we can able to modify or we can able to clone, but we cannot remove these standard profiles given by the Salesforce. These are the various standard profiles given by the Salesforce to you. Now when you go to these profiles, like if you're having these profiles like charter external user profile, and then these profiles are associated with the license. What is that license? This is a license here. Nothing but this is the charter free. Okay, now these two are associated with the charter free license, and this is associated with the charter external license. When you go to these two licenses are associated, profiles are associated with only one type of license. Nothing but analytics cloud integration user. Now, when you go to that custom marketing profile, you will be associated with the Salesforce license. Now contact manager will be associated with the license called as Salesforce license. Nothing but what happened? We are having that license. Now one profile can be associated with only one license, but multiple profile, one license can be assigned to the multiple profiles also. Okay. So now every profile will be associated with one license, not the multiple licenses. But one license can be get assigned to the multiple profiles. With the same Salesforce license, we are having the multiple profiles are available. For the Salesforce license, we are having contract manager profile and the custom marketing profile. And when moving forward, you will be having some more profiles are also available. See, now the custom Salesforce sales profile and the custom support profile, these are also associated with the Salesforce license. Nothing but one license can have multiple profiles also. That flexibility will be available. But always one profile can be associated with only one license, not with the multiple licenses here. Now, when coming to these users, we are going to be using these profiles to be get associated with that user. Whenever you are going to be associating with that user, then automatically one license will be getting assigned to that user automatically by default here. Now, so now when coming to the Salesforce here. So now how can we create your own custom profile? In order to create that custom profile, let's use this navigation here. So now in order to create a custom profile, we have to use this navigation. So now if you want to create the custom profile, then we can able to create the custom profile by cloning an existing one. Instead of creating the profile by your own from the scratch everything, just we can able to make a clone of an existing profile and we can able to do the required modifications inside that, depends upon your need. So now why? Because is when coming to the standard profile, we cannot able to modify all the settings of standard profile, so that Salesforce is always recommending you to go for your custom profile. Create your custom profile and assign that custom profile to your users. Now, in that custom profile, you can do whatever the changes that you want. You can restrict whatever the permission that you want, depends upon your need. That flexibility will be available to you. So that here, always we are going to be creating our own custom profile and then we are going to be assigning that custom profile to our users. Then how can we create a custom profile here? Now let's see practically here. In order to create a new custom profile, we have to go to that administer menu again and then go to that manage users. And inside that manager users, you will be having that profiles link. As of now, you are aware of that. When you go to that profiles, you will be having a button called as new profile button to create a new profile. And then enter the profile name with which you want to create right now. And select that license type, nothing but based on which license you want to create the profile. And then which profile you would like to make a clone, you can able to select that profile from the pick list field. And then it is going to be, when you click on save button, automatically your profile will be getting created for you. So now let's see here. Now we are having the profiles are available, which are stored inside that profile object. I want to create a new profile right now. Click on new profile. So now whenever you are going to be creating a profile, which profile you would like to make a clone here? I would like to clone a profile called as Salesforce Standard User. So now the standard user profile I would like to clone, because standard user is of type, the license type is Salesforce type. Nothing but this profile is associated with that Salesforce license. So now the profile name, what is the name that you want to give? I want to specify the training Salesforce profile. I'm giving the name as training Salesforce profile. Now inside a single license, we can able to have the multiple profiles also here. And then now click on save. Your profile has been created automatically. Now your profile has been created with the name training Salesforce profile. This is the profile has been given to you. If you want to assign this profile to any user, then you can click on view users and then you can cross check this profile is using by, or this profile has been referenced by the which users. You can able to cross check that. Now, I want to create one more profile over here. I'm creating one more profile. Click on new button to create a new profile. Now in this case,
so always I need to clone from Firoz. I need to clone from the existing profiles. Yes. We cannot create a new.
Yes, always we have to make a clone from that existing profile only. We cannot create everything from the scratch.
So what is the difference in that case? I am giving a standard platform user and this profile is same, right? What I am gaining here? Like, I don't understand. Sorry.
See. So now, whenever you are going to be creating the profile, inside that profile, whatever the permission that you want to grant, that will be visible to only that associated platform. See, for example, if you are using that Salesforce profile will be associated with that Salesforce license. Now in that license will decide to you what applications they can able to access by using this license. Okay, what applications they can able to access by using this license. Now in that license, there will be clearly mentioned that what features of Salesforce they can able to access. Now, when coming to the platform license, there will be describing that with this license, we can able to access this kind of permission. See, for example, coming to your, for example, I'm having some driving licenses are there. Suppose if you're having the two-wheeler license, then you can able to travel only by bike on the roads. But if you're having some three-wheeler license, then we can able to bike, we can able to travel by the two-wheeler license, nothing but two-wheeler bikes also, we can go with that, the three-wheelers also here. If you're having that four-wheeler, then we can able to use this one for the two-wheelers and the three-wheelers and the four-wheelers also here. Nothing but what happened here, when coming to the Salesforce license is going to be describing that whatever the Salesforce functionalities are available, it may be standard, it may be custom, everything we can able to access that. If it is a platform license, only the platform functionalities we can able to access that will be described by the platform license to you. Okay.
Thank you, Phil.
Yeah.
But here it is not possible, Firoz, like if you have a car license, you cannot ride bike in US.
No. So, but here in India, everything is possible. If you are having Now. So now here, I'm creating the license now profile right now, which is a training platform profile. Now I'm going to be cloning the profile, which is a standard platform user. So now this profile, I'm going to be cloning right now with a new name called as training platform profile. So now why? Because is here, we are having that Salesforce is giving the two Salesforce licenses to us. They have given the three platform licenses to us. So for that here, I'm going to be creating those profiles in terms of Salesforce license profile and the platform license profile in order to present to my users. Now, so now we have created two profiles right now. One is the Salesforce licensed profile. Second one is the platform licensed profile. So now this training platform profile is associated with the Salesforce platform license and the training Salesforce profile, which we have created previously, that will be associated with the Salesforce license to you. So now these are the two profiles that we have created right now, which are associated with the two different licenses. Now, so now when coming to the profile, we can able to assign this profile to the user right now. Now let's create the user here. Observe what will happen in this case. So now I would like to add the new users inside that. How can we manage the users inside your Salesforce organization? So now once you have created the profile, once the profile is ready, then we can able to assign this profile to your users also. Then how can we create the users? Now let's see here. So now we can create one or more users to a single profile. Okay, inside an organization, we can have the multiple users, but where whenever you are going to be creating a user, every user should be associated with a profile. That is a mandatory thing. Okay, that is a mandatory thing that every user should have associated with a profile. Without designing the profile, we cannot able to create the user record inside that Salesforce. That is a mandatory field. Nothing but when coming to the entry point of view, they will raise a question, what is the difference between role and a profile? When coming to the profile, profile is a mandatory field upon creating a user record. Without designing the profile, we cannot create a user record in Salesforce. And that too, one user can be associated with only one profile at a time, not the multiple. But one profile can be associated with multiple users also. Now, so now for that here, we are going to be creating the user record. In order to grant access on my Salesforce applications to some more users, we are going to be adding those members as the users. Now each user should be associated with a license, and without that user license, we cannot create a user record in Salesforce. And upon creating that user record, we have to provide the profile. Nothing but profile is a mandatory field upon creating a user record. And after that, we will be having some certain navigation is available to create that users. So now, in order to create that user, we have to go to that same menu, like as the administer menu. And then in that administer menu, you will be having an option called as manage users. Inside that manage users, you will be having that users link. And then you have to click on that new button in order to create a new user record, where we have to enter all the details, like as your first name, last name, email ID, and the username, and the nickname, and the alias name, title, company name, everything we can able to enter inside that. And along with that, we have to select the profile. Nothing but which profile you want to make it associated to this user. So now we have to select that. And when you click on save button, again, this is also the two-step process again to you here. So now, as soon as whenever you are creating the new user by using these details, then as soon as when you click on save button, it is going to be creating a new user record inside that Salesforce, but the user account will not be in active status to you. So for that here, in order to log in into that account by using this user credentials, now if we have to go to that email notification, we have to click on that, we have to activate that user account, and then by providing the password in the confirm password. Whenever you are creating the Salesforce account, whatever the two-step process is there, exactly the same two-step process is available here also upon creating a new user record. Whenever you are going to be joining into a Salesforce organization as a Salesforce developer inside a team, now those Salesforce administrator people will collect your details and they will be adding you as a new user inside that application. Then only you will be able to access that functionality. We can able to work on those applications also. Now, so now in tomorrow's session, we are going to discuss how can we create the users and how can we manage the users inside that Salesforce organization. We'll see practically in tomorrow's session.
Okay. Thank you, Firoz.
Okay, thank you.
Firoz, do we have a class tomorrow? Same time?
Yes, we have the class tomorrow same time.
Okay, Firoz, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Yeah, Firoz, please upload a day before yesterday's session also.
Okay. I will upload that. And regarding this today's session, I would like to give some theoretical documentation inside that drive so that you can able to access that.
Oh, thank you, Firoz. Okay. It is confusing a little bit.
Okay, sure.
Thank you.